Hi all, welcome once again to Jackie Blue of Beauty Tips and welcome to my channel. I have a beauty channel and I talk about also about health, fitness, lifestyle, fashion, all kinds of things. So I feel like there's something for everyone. So come on down, be part of my YouTube family and be one of my chickadees. And always please like, comment and subscribe. So today's video is gonna be about applying your makeup techniques to look younger. And as we get older, we have to change a little bit of our makeup. Not too much, just, you know, tweak it. And there's a couple techniques that I wanted to share with you that are easy to do, and I think they make a big difference. And I've learned this through trial and error and, you know, just some things that I picked up along the way. So first of all, I'm going to talk about your skin, that you need to take care of your skin, and I do believe in moisturizer. So the first thing I do is have clean face, moisturized, and when I go for a foundation, I don't go for a matte. I go for a satin or a dewy look. And that's because I think when it's more dewy and not dry and powdery, that screams youthfulness, and I just think it brings a glow to your skin. So I always go for dewy, I go for a light foundation, and I use cream blush most of the time. Or if I do use a powder blush, I'll mix it with a little bit of moisturizer to make it more dewy. And when you're applying your blush, do not go too low. I think you can go liberal because again, that makes you more youthful if you have more color. And I usually go with a peach or a pink. And I blend it well, but you know, I just like the creams better because they're not powdery. And I don't use powder at all, unless in summer, if it's a really humid day, I might use a little bit because I feel like that dry look, and then I think that a lot of the powders just set in your lines. So if you have a really good powder that doesn't do that, go ahead and use it. But I usually skip powder because to me, it just seems like it ages my face. Another big tip is to use some kind of a primer. What I use is a Monistat, which is a chafing gel. And it seems to work like a primer, and I just tap it in my lines as kind of like a filler or a spackle, and it seems to work really well. So that's something you might want to try. Also, I do use bronzer because I think it brings a glow, not a lot of it. I kind of just use it kind of like a little contouring around my face and maybe a little on my nose just for a little glow. And a really big tip is if you're getting a little bit of gels, which we all get as we get older, to use either a bronzer or a darker foundation or even like some kind of contouring stick, and you just put it right along here and then you blend it down a little bit, and that seems to just, you know, get rid of that and conceal it a little bit. So that's pretty much for the face what I do. Now when it comes to your lips, I just think lighter colors are better as we get older, but if you like red and you're darker complected, you know, go ahead and use your red. I do use red on occasion for something special, like a special occasion. And I usually use either a shade darker or the same shade as my lips. And the lining them, you have to be careful. You can overline them to make them look fuller on top here, but as you go down, stick with your line. Don't go too wide or you look like Joker and it will age you. And then again, as you come down here, don't overline until you get to the center here. Then you can overline a little bit just to make it a little plumper. And always moisturize right here. Don't use any powder right here because it'll make you have more lines like smokers get. So that's pretty much for my face. I wanted to talk about concealer too. I use a light concealer because I am fair and I think it makes my eyes look brighter. But some people say you should just kind of match your foundation. I do go with a little lighter concealer, so I don't know if that's what everyone wants to do. But when you're using concealer, just do it where it's darker. You don't have to do, you know, a big swoop here, just kind of where you have, like I kind of go down here where it's a little dark and then a little bit here and then blend it in. And don't go too heavy on the concealer. And then you always want to lift, like you want to pat it and have your eyeshadow kind of go lift up. You don't want anything coming too far down because it's going to weight you down. You always got to think lift, lift, lift. You can use a lip gloss, that's fine too, or any kind of plumpers, that works just great. That's what I do, you know, for my lips and my face. Now I'm going to talk about the eyebrows. Don't go crazy with your eyebrows. I feel like, you know, just a little bit, not too dark, not too thick, just kind of you know, fill them in a little bit, have a little arch, and then come down a little low, but not, you know, too low. And, you know, I don't think you have to get too fancy with the eyebrows. I think that, you know, if you do too much, I don't think it looks good on a older face. That's just me. So that's the eyebrows. And now about the eye makeup, which is a big one. We want to play up our eyes because that will, you know, bring attention to ourselves, make us look brighter and more youthful. And if your eyes aren't done up, I feel like it kind of takes the eye away from some other areas on your face that might not, you know, be perfect. For the eyes, you can use some frost or satin shadows, but you don't, just on the lid. I wouldn't do it on the crease or the outer V, or you could use a little bit just under the brow here, a little shimmer, because that just kind of, you know, gives you a little sparkle. And then when you're going for your crease, always use a matte, because frost right there will make you look older. And as you're doing your crease, just go with a brush like this, you know, in your crease, and then you want to go up just a little bit to conceal any hooded eyes you might have. And that seems to really create, you know, create that open eye look. And let's see what else. And you can use a little bit of white, like right here in the middle of the dot to brighten up, or a little white eyeliner. I put a little white right there just to brighten it up. And that seems to be more youthful. So that's pretty much with the eyeshadow. And then when you're using eyeliner, I don't go with black. Unless you're dark complected, I think that a brown is softer and looks better. And if you're going with the wing, just a slight wing, unless you can pull it off. You know, like I said, all these rules, you know, they're just suggestions. They're not in stone. Whatever really looks good on you, go ahead and do. But I feel like the black eyeliner, especially on the bottom, maybe on the top lid, okay. On the bottom lid, it's gonna drag it down. And so either use a brown or else just do a smoky with a light brown eyeshadow and a little brush, just put a little bit around. I think that looks pretty too. That's pretty much for the eyes. Oh yeah, mascara, I would go with the long lengthening, not a clumpy, because again, the clumpy is gonna weigh down your eyes. And I don't do my bottom lashes except for a little bit on the side here. So that's pretty much the eyes. So I think those are all my tips. We'll post of half my face using my techniques to look younger and the other half doing the no-nose, and you'll see the difference on me. So obviously this is a different day. I have a different sweater on. Yesterday I had my makeup the same on both sides. So today when I got up, I did one half, you know, with the techniques that I said to look younger, and the other half, you know, I did the no-nose. So I think you can see which half. Yeah, this is the half that I did the no-nose, and this is the half that I did the techniques to look a little bit younger. And you can see it's more youthful. And I even used similar colors. If you use harsher colors, you would even see more of a difference, because I think as you get older, you should use, you know, softer colors, and that way it's not as harsh and you look younger. Like I was discussing, sides have the same foundation on. This side has a light L'Oreal powder. This does not. This side has a little bronzer here and here to give it a little glow. This side does not. This side is a cream blush, and this side is a powder blush. And like I said, you can use a powder blush, but when I do, if I want to make it more creamy, after I put it on, I use this little moisturizing vitamin E stick. And I'll just kind of put a little over it, and that'll make it look a little more creamy and not as powdery and dry. So that's how I use my powder, because I have lots of pretty powder blushes. On this side, I use, this is what I was talking about, the Monistat Care Chafing Relief Powder Gel that I use kind of like a primer on my line. So I used it on this side and not on that side. And then with my lips, it was the same color, but as you can see, I overlined all the way up, and I think it, you know, was kind of aging. This side looks a little more like a plump, youthful lip. And let's see what else. Of course, the eyes, the eyebrows, much heavier here and curved, and I think, you know, it looks better, softer. The eyeliner was a black eyeliner, and on this side it was a brown. It was the same brand I used, just different colors. And right on my lid, it was the same color eyeshadow, but when I did the crease, I have a frost on this one or a shimmer, and on this one I have a matte, which I think that made a difference too. And on this side I use a lot of concealer all over here, which you can see it's kind of too much. Here I just use it mainly where my shadow was, there and a little bit there. And I also lift it more on this side. As you see, when I put the eyeshadow on, I had it lift, and here I didn't, and I just kind of let it go out. The same color under my brow. I put mascara on the lower lashes also on this side, which I think weights it down. On this side, I just did a few, you know, on the little bit of the edge of my eye in the bottom. I didn't do it all the way around. I think that is the big difference. And like I said, a younger person could pull this all off, but as we mature, we have to have a softer look. And I think, you know, these youthful techniques really make a difference. I think I mentioned everything. So I hope you enjoyed this video and that it helped and that you could maybe share some of your youthful tips with me too. Like I always say, the smile's the best beauty tip. If you're happy on the inside, it'll show on the outside. And I will see you in my next video. So love you all. Take care. Peace out. Bye-bye.